If I told you to picture people in medieval Europe, you'll probably picture short, sickly people covered in dirt and their own filth, wearing ragged, bland-colored clothes that they've never washed, just like themselves. But medieval Europe was bright, colorful. Both the happy and sad could be found among rich and poor, wearing bright, colored, clean clothes. They washed themselves along with their clothes, seeking to look and smell their best, as well as maintain their health. They weren't fools. They knew that filth invited sickness. A 16th century tradesman named Lucas Rym recorded in his diary bathing 127 times over 3 weeks. That's 6 times a day. How many of us bathe more than once a day? Now, not all those visits to the baths may have been for cleanliness, but clearly the baths were important to Lucas, and it wasn't just him. 1,000 years earlier, at the start of the Middle Ages, Pope Gregory I recommended everyone to take Sunday baths, but warned to avoid them becoming a time-wasting luxury. But that warning against excess bathing wasn't a call against cleanliness, but a call against other activities that occurred at the baths, which we'll cover later. In the 13th century in On the Preservation of Health, it reads, "When you get up in the morning, stretch your limbs so that the natural heat is stimulated. Then comb your hair because it removes dirt and comforts the brain. Wash your face with cold water to give your skin a good color and to stimulate the natural heat. Clear your nose and your chest by coughing, and clean your teeth and gums with bark of some scented tree." Here we learn a lot about their hygiene practices, but towards washing we learn that not all washing needed to be bathing. Here it talks of cold water, but one might also warm the water in a little basin, and with cloth and soap, scrub away the dirt and smells from their whole body without immersing in water. But if one desired, one could wash in a stream or river, but that risked drowning. We have many records of that occurring. So also a private basin or the bathhouses would be a better option, as you would avoid the risk of drowning. Every town and city had a bathhouse, many. Enough to regulate both the conduct and price. They even used the old Roman baths. People used bathhouses for more than just cleanliness, as we talked about. They had steaming hot pools and cool pools. One might get their clothes washed and get a massage. One could relax in a pool with friends and strangers, enjoying food and music while discussing business or gossip. And why not, if you're there, enjoy the services of a bathhouse maid, a prostitute? If it was for that extracurricular activity that the church warned against going to the baths too often. Bathing was needed to wash away the filth of life, but it was also a leisure activity and could also bring some other filth. It is true that one might not bathe every day, but they'll wash every day. One would get dirty in their daily lives. One might smell from the smoke of all the fires, but they had remedies of oil, spices, and herbs to make deodorants to deal with that. They also had soaps made of fats, oils, and wood ash. These soaps work really well and have existed since ancient Mesopotamia, at least that long ago. Now, it is true, some monks and saints did avoid bathing, but that was to rid themselves of worldly pleasures. Those who inflict self-harm upon themselves to be more pious has always been a thing, especially among them. So that was a case of that. Now, during severe plague outbreaks, people avoided the baths, but as not to bathe in the same water that a sick individual might have bathed in. They would still bathe. They bathed at home. And also, they bathed the sick to help them heal better. They desired cleanliness for both their appearance and health. Thus is why they bathed. They had bathhouses. They were big on bathing. They even required washing your hands before eating, as not to consume the filth. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe. A few sources and other resources may be found in the description below.